So, how are commercial maps made? I have no idea. I am not a GIS professional, but I have been surveying for OpenStreetMap for 14 years. And surveying for OpenStreetMap is a bit distinct, because it is not as professional. We don't chase like accuracy, we don't chase like millimeter precision, but we need to collect a lot of data and make it good enough. So how do we do that in OpenStreetMap? We basically, you need to make tools like fun and efficient. And I think that in commercial context, in like grown-up geese and JS, there are not like goals for serving apps. Because apps that I have seen, there are those big apps that are hard to use with long forms and that take like a couple of minutes for every point. And it is rarely fun unless you like take pleasure from that. And not very efficient, because I often saw how you have to fill long forms and it takes time and it's just so tedious. Ah. So here I want to like connect those two worlds to show you how it's done in OpenStreetMap. So maybe you have some ideas for the next time you make some surveying project, especially with a lot of people. So what is the most simple way you can collect data in the forest? Well, it's obvious. It's pen and paper, basically, or in the city. Yeah, you go to the city, you see some area that's poorly mapped, and you start drawing roads and buildings and a fence here and pedestrian walkways and some points like shops and stuff like that. That I did it like 10 years ago. Right now it's simpler, right? I have an editor called Evidor, and this year I have added basically the same thing, but in a phone. Basically, you open the editor and look around you and position yourself and start drawing. Like, here's a road, and you see some stream crossing it, and you see pedestrian paths going out to the forest. And also, like, you can add labels, like drag it and type something like surface, like ground, I don't know. And press a button. It all goes to the internet. What does it mean? It means that then I open a desktop editor, I add satellite imagery, GPS trace, all the other data sources, and this layer. And I can start tracing everything and make it more precise than I could do it on the ground. All I needed was some geometric nodes. Geometric nodes, very powerful, a simple concept. Because when preparing for serving, people usually like invent complex data models. They invent complex software, like with editing of line strings and polygons. But really, most often, all you need is just circle some things, add some labels, and like do the rest at home. You don't need to draw geometry on the screen. You have fingers, and from the childhood you learned how to draw. Use it for mapping. That's one thing. What about others? Well, surveying OpenStreetMap right now is a bit of a problem because OpenStreetMap has so much data. So when mapping, it's really hard to find what's missing and what not, what's outdated. So for my app that's primarily aimed at mapping shops, I had to invent something, so I don't use markers on the map. Because when there's really high density, think trees in a forest, right? Seeing hundreds of markers on the mobile screen is not fun. Like, you can't use it, because how do you know what to tap? How do you know what's missing in this tree of markers? I don't know. So instead, I thought, like, do I need an interactive map? And turns out you don't, because you just a list is enough. How do you use list? It's simple. I walk in a shopping mall, I confirm my location, and I see like shops around me sorted by distance. And that way I immediately see what is missing and can add missing stuff. But also, lists allow adding all the like information on the screen, like names, like opening hours, phones, floor, like icons for card payments and stuff. It's already there. I don't have to tap anything. I see what data is missing already, and I can update it. Like, I know what to tap. So this also helps with like keeping the data fresh. All I had to do was to put interactive map aside. And that's what you could take from it. Like, you don't always need a map. I have made a talk at Baltic JIT about that. Sometimes a list is enough. Sometimes text with a button can be enough. Add marker to your position. Why not? Try using it. It's really simple. You could, I don't know, once you get used to it, why do we even use interactive maps? Another thing is from different data. Like, you know how OpenStreetMap has like hundreds of thousands of mappers? And it's very popular. And the second most popular editor, named StreetComplete, and it has also a different approach. Like, we love, when we want to collect as much data as possible, we invent long forms, complex processes, stuff like that. But what about, like, when I'm just sitting in the bus stop, waiting, like, I have 6 minutes until my bus, and I want to improve OpenStreetMap, I want to help. What do? I almost did complete. And it shows me like questions. Like, do these steps have a handrail? Or like, what's the name of this road? What is the surface? Does this pedestrian crossing have a tactile pavement? Like, lots of small questions that I can answer in a second. I answer it, there's another, and there's another. I gain points from it, some virtual points, and it also, like, from points I get levels, and there's leaderboards, and it's pretty exciting. It's like playing a game, but a game that every tap helps OpenStreetMap. And you can borrow it, right? You can borrow the idea, because sometimes your data collection project doesn't need a lot of data. Sometimes in just the first step, is there, do you see any like waste disposal places? Yeah, I do. There. Okay, next. Seconds. But it collects like millions of data points to OpenStreetMap. Isn't that exciting? So maybe making your app as simple as possible, making it casual, can drive in a lot more people that together can fill your database. And the last thing, I also wanted to add about long forms, because I really had seen like surveying tools with long forms and people had to fill in. Of course, collecting shops, we need to fill long forms. Like I open every door at a mall and I have to fill shop type and name and address, like house number and street and opening hours and wheelchair access and card payments, website, a phone, operator, room number, tons of fields, right? Isn't it boring? Isn't it tedious? Well, not anymore, because I didn't approach it as a list of fields, right? I tried to make it as optimized as possible. Some fields can be joined together, like house number and street name, making up an address. I just list addresses around, so I don't have to type street name. I just have to tap on an address. And it works. For some fields, can be hidden, like card payments. Can you pay with card? Yes, no, only with card. And it hides like multiple fields inside. But for me, I approach it from customer point of view. Yeah, okay, I can pay with card. Websites can be made from QR codes. And some fields like opening hours need a special like complex processing. But generally it becomes very fast. Because all the you approach it not from a database point of view, but from a customer point of view. So it is simpler to grasp. You don't have to spend your mind like cycles on mapping database model to real world. It's already there. So what it teaches us is that think how you build a form. Think from point of view of surveyor. Like maybe you can make it simpler, make it faster for them. And you will collect more data because it won't be as tedious. And with that, maybe your project can be as fun as OpenStreetMap. If not, just install every door in Street Complete, two apps that I mentioned today. Tap around, maybe you could add some data to OpenStreetMap, and maybe you can get some ideas for your app. And yeah, that's what I wanted to show. Thank you, I'm Ilya Zverev, easily Googleable. So, map OpenStreetMap, make better apps. Thank you and goodbye.